What's up? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Nay. If you're new, thank you guys so much for clicking on this video. So today's video is going to be all about spring cleaning. I love spring cleaning. I love decluttering. I literally do spring cleaning probably a couple times a year. I just wanted to share with you guys some of the most overlooked things that people forget to do when they're spring cleaning. There is a lot that goes into spring cleaning. I totally understand that. There's tons of checklists, tons of things that you can do and follow to make sure that you are getting every area of your life spring cleaned. But I want to share with you guys 15 things that I think are important that a lot of people overlook and that you should be doing this year when you spring clean. So the first thing on my list of spring cleaning to-dos is to flip or rotate your mattress. A lot of people overlook this just because it's a big one and they don't really know that you're supposed to flip and rotate your mattress. I read that you're supposed to be doing it every... So I read that you are supposed to flip your mattress or rotate your mattress twice a year. It actually expands the life of your mattress and it also helps with spine alignment, especially if you're sleeping with two people. The mattress can get kind of pushed in depending on the weight of each person and where you're putting the majority of your weight. So flipping the mattress around not only expands the life of the mattress, but also with your health by improving your sleep. So the second thing on my list is to replace your shower liner. If you have no shower doors and you use a shower curtain and you use a shower liner, the shower liner can get really moldy and being with all the water, it can definitely get very smelly and increase bacteria in your bathroom. So switching out your shower liner is super inexpensive. I think they're like $2 at Target, and I tend to do this probably 3 to 4 times a year. So the third thing on my list is to wash your pillows. When you put your head on your pillows, you're accumulating a lot of bacteria just because sometimes we don't always wash our face before we fall asleep, or the makeup and the oil that is on our face goes and seeps into the pillows, which you can always wash the pillowcases, but the pillows themselves get super dirty as well. You can always replace your pillows as well, but that can get kind of expensive. And I tend to have like a lot of pillows on my bed, so I like to clean my pillows. Not only does it help reduce all the bacteria that you've gotten into your pillows, but also the smell. If you guys ever have been into kind of like an older person's home and they have a lot of the same stuff that they've had for like years and years, they kind of get like this musty smell, and I think the reason behind that is because they don't always clean things that aren't necessarily the first thought of to be cleaned, like pillows and stuff. I just throw my pillows in my washer with Odor Cleanse laundry additive. This stuff is amazing. It gets rid of all the smells, but you can also use it with your detergent so you can get the smelling good smell, but it reduces all that odor that comes with, you know, sleeping on your pillows for long periods of time and the smell and the mustiness that comes with older items that you don't really necessarily want to get rid of because it can be expensive. I also use this stuff for my workout clothes just to get rid of the nasty smells. This stuff is amazing. I really highly recommend it. If you guys want to try it, I'll leave it linked down below. I put this in with my pillows. I wash two pillows at a time and then I always put them in the dryer. I just wash them normally. It kind of takes a while for the pillows to get back to their normal self, but make sure that you're drying them in the dryer, just two at a time. Putting too many in the dryer isn't always the best idea. So the third thing that you should do when you're spring cleaning that a lot of people forget is to go through your fridge items. Literally go shelf by shelf. Just take everything out of your fridge. Not only should you clean the inside of your fridge and your freezer, but also go through everything that's expired. This also goes for your pantry. Take out every single thing. If you've had specific things that have expired, throw them away. If you have things that you don't necessarily want and you've just been keeping them in there, maybe donate them to a kitchen or something. Going through your fridge and your pantry and just decluttering that is a huge relief because you can find things easily, you can organize them better when placing them back, and then also your shelves are much cleaner as well. So the third thing on my list is your blinds, windows, and your window seals. A lot of the times we clean the inside of our windows. If you're not in a two-story building, going outside and actually cleaning the exterior part of your window is also really beneficial. Something else that I do is like on the top of the window, like where you open it, there's like a little ledge, and I'll clean that because that can get a lot of dust, as well as the window seal at the bottom. That accumulates a lot of dust, and when you open and close the windows, the stuff from the outside and the dirt and dust and sometimes bugs can get in, and cleaning that off and getting all the dirt and dust off is really great. And then also your blinds. Now this can take a little bit of a while, but it's totally worth it because blinds accumulate so much dust, it's unreal. So I go through every single blind and I'll just quickly dust off anything that needs to be dusted. It doesn't look like there's that much much dust, but trust me, when you do this, you're like, oh my gosh, I can't believe the blinds accumulated that much dust. It makes you just feel so much better knowing that all that dust is gone. So the next thing on my list is your crown molding and your baseboards. This again can create a lot of dust. I actually do this in my normal cleaning routine when I had a studio apartment, but a lot of the times people live in bigger places than just a studio or one bedroom. So going through your crown molding and your baseboards can be a lot, but what I do is I actually take a dryer sheet and I'll go along the bottom of the baseboards and the crown molding. The dryer sheet actually picks up all the dust, so all you have to do is swipe through. You don't have to spray anything. You literally just take the dryer sheet and you just go along the bottom of the baseboard and it accumulates the dust. So just walking around the house real quick with a dryer sheet is a really great hack for spring cleaning. So the next thing on my list is behind your appliances, like your fridge or your stove, unplugging them and taking them from the wall. That bottom area accumulates not only dust, but like old food. It could be dead bugs under there. Like you have no idea what's under there, honestly. It could be really gross and there could be oil down there or spills that you may have spilled, like when you were cooking or something. Unplugging those and then just swiping that down once a year makes for a better spring cleaning next year and the next year after that, because you are keeping in tune with that. The worst thing is taking that out of the outlet and then moving it and then just seeing like the most disgusting thing ever, and having that in your house. Like your house can be spick and clean, but when you remove the appliances, that's where a lot of the times people don't clean, because it's just a hassle to remove the stove and everything. Just be super careful if you do this and hold your nose. So the next thing on my list are patio floors. Going through and sweeping all the dust and leaves and bugs and dirt that comes with your patio or exterior. And if you have a pressure washer, you can also go through and use the pressure washer to kind of clean the concrete to make for a better appearance. And then if you do pressure wash, it will literally make your house just pop, because you have that extra nice sparkle and shine to your concrete that everyone else just has like dirt. So the next thing on my list is your furniture, especially your couch. I did this last time I deep cleaned and I found that, wow, my couch is disgusting. When you take off the cushions and you actually clean underneath your couch, you can find money maybe, you can find wrappers and old food and crumbs that are just ugh, as well as a ton of dust. Again, taking off the cushions of your couch, cleaning the cushions of your couch, you can actually do that too, but really getting in the depths of the furniture is a really great way to, you know, just feel better about sitting down on all the stuff that you didn't know that you were sitting on. So the next thing that I have is to go through all of your drawers and cabinets. This one might take a few days, but what I do is I literally take everything out. I go cabinet by cabinet, drawer by drawer, take everything out, clean the bottom of it, as well as organize and declutter everything that's in there. Even that drawer that people say, like, you have this like clutter drawer, go through that and make it organized. No one should have a clutter drawer. I just hate the feeling of clutter. It brings me negative vibes. I just feel so much better when everything is organized and everything has a place and I know where everything is. It just creates for a less stressful life and everyday routine. It can be a little bit overwhelming. Try your best just to do one drawer at a time. So the next thing on my list are your trash cans. A lot of the times people think trash cans are supposed to be dirty, they're trash, whatever. You should probably clean your trash can at least once or twice a year, inside the trash can, outside the trash can, and on the bottom. Especially the trash can that's out in your garage or outside, that can accumulate not only like a smell, but also just like a lot of bacteria and just really gross, you know, things. So cleaning it with like a hose or cleaning it with like Windex or all-purpose cleaner, putting like trash can bags back in it so that next time it will be easier. If you are the type of person that doesn't use trash bags, I really highly recommend to use trash bags. It just makes your life so much easier and there's no gross stuff actually in the trash can. So the next thing on my list are appliances. This means your fridge, your washer. You can also use that odor cleanse that I told you earlier in your washer as well, just to remove all those smells and gunk that's in your washer. You can clean your microwave, which can get really gross. There's actually a setting on your stove where it cleans itself and it gets super super hot, so be so careful if you do this, but doing that, it just like burns everything inside and just cleans it for you. The next thing on my list are fans. That can accumulate a lot of dust as well, and we don't always see it because we don't look up the ceiling, so we don't know how much dust is on our fans unless we like actually get up there and start sweeping it clean. It is so gross. And the fact that the fan is going, it's like pushing all that dirt and dust into the air. It's not really creating that clean, purified, fresh air that you want to be, you know, breathing in every day and having flown all around your house. So cleaning up your fans, as well as the stand-up fans, if you have one of those like ones that like turn, I don't even know what they're called, going through all the vents and like cleaning that fan and taking it apart is also a really great way to like purify your air as well. That can actually be where a lot of the dust comes from in your house. If you tend to get a really, really dusty home, try checking your fan. The next thing I have is to go through all of your stuff. And by stuff, I mean clothes, your makeup, hair product, jewelry, all the stuff in your bathroom, just all the stuff that you have. Put it in a pile of donations, keeping, or I don't know. When you put in the I don't know items, really look at it and see if you've used it within the past year or if it brings a sort of happiness to you. If it brings nothing to you, you should probably donate it. If you're not the type of person to like get rid of a lot of stuff and you just have a ton of stuff and you wish you were that type of person, look at the item and see, what does it bring me? Does it bring you good feelings or does it bring you bad feelings? Is there like a memory associated with it? Can you live without it? Is it the end of the world if you get rid of it? Always, always donate. I think it's so important to donate just because a lot of the people don't have the privilege that we have of having all this stuff and decluttering, having the need to like clean a house that we have and going through all the stuff that we've accumulated through the years. So donating is a really great way to give back to other people. I have a huge box that I just kind of accumulated when I did spring cleaning. Is there like a past tense of spring cleaning? Spring clang. But yeah, I have a whole box I'm gonna be donating, so definitely make sure that you donate. And the last and final tip, which I think a lot of people overlook, is to spring clean your computer and your phone. Organize and clean and delete things that you don't need. Go through your photos, go through your email and your messages, unsubscribe from certain things on your email, just literally go through them all. Just delete the things that you don't really need so it creates more storage for your phone and computers. Also, organizing your apps into like little boxes. If you have an iPhone, I organize all mine into like, you know, social media, I have creativity, I have health. Another thing I do with my photos is I'll import them into my computer and then I actually have a hard drive, like a little disk that I will put all my photos in and then organize them according to date. So like 2016, 2017, 2018, and then having it on that disk will get rid of it on your computer as well as your phone, and it will give you so much more storage. You can also go through all of your music. If you are a music hoarder, you can always organize all the past ones. Again, you can just put your music through the years, so like 2016, 17, 18. So you can always go back and see like what you were listening to, and it could be like your little throwback playlist. Another thing is going through all of your contacts, deleting people that you no longer even know or even talk to. If it's been years or you don't even know who the person is in your contacts, probably delete it. Going through your history as well online or your Google searches, that can also give you a ton more storage. I actually use Omni Disk Sweeper. That is something that I believe you should be watching a tutorial before you use, because you can actually delete stuff and then no longer have it. It just shows you every little file that's in your computer that's not necessarily seen on your end. So when I delete photos, like I could still have the photos somewhere in there. I have no idea where they are, but I always use that Omni Disk Sweeper and make sure that everything that I deleted is actually deleted and off my computer, again, increasing my storage so much. So that is it for this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys do any of these things, let me know. If I miss something, let me know. I will see you guys all in another video soon. Bye guys!